Good morning, and welcome to another fabulous day of learning at Oakview Elementary School, where our vision is to promote a high-performing culture and climate that inspires our community of learners to achieve academic excellence. Our mission is to reach, to teach, and to equip, and our theme for the year is maximizing our potential. Let's all pause now so that we can recite our student creed.
I am an Oakview Elementary School student. I have great expectations for myself. I accept the challenge to become the best student that I can be. I'm proud of my school. The vision of Oakview is to promote a high-performing culture and climate that inspires our community of learning to achieve academic excellence. I accept the responsibility for my behavior and its results. I'm determined to be safe, responsible, productive, and respectful. I have high expectations for myself, and I will respect my potential. I choose to be great.
This question is from Michael Quarterman. How old am I? When is my birthday? And I already told you that I have two daughters. So I am not going to tell you guys how old I am. We're just going to say I'm old enough. Okay? And we'll say your principal is over the age of 40. So I will tell you that. My birthday is on February the 5th. That's all for me today. Let's have a great day, Oakview.
Attention 3rd through 5th grade scholars, Oakview Elementary will be hosting our cheerleading team. Make sure you submit your applications and physical exams by September 29th, 2022 to Ms. Deadweiler, Ms. Pierce, or Ms. Pollard. On September 29th, a cheer, chant, and dance clinic. On September 30th, a jumps motions clinic. On October 3rd, stunts tumbling clinic. October 4th, cheer tryouts. And October 6th, the team reveal day. Good luck, Oakview Owls. We want to give a big shout out to the following students for making the drama team: Melody Lassiter, Winston Hudson, Demencia Merchantson, Legacy McKay, King Hodrick, Jeremy Okumbor, Genoa Bly, Poetry Grimsley, Jamari Griffin, Xavion Streets, Faith Perry, Emery Lloyd, Makai Bankhead, Dahlia Flagg, Cameron White, Maddox Cameron, Karma Collins, Mariah Banks, Winter Hudson, Erica Boswell, Tanisia Thompson, and Josiah Coney. We want to give a big shout out to our Drama Club extras: Rhea McMullen, Dejanay Laurent, Anaya Streeter, Kalia Carroll, Zane Bettis, Travis Gathers, Paige Sales, Christian Roberts, Cameron White, King Bettis, Amaya Battle, and Madison Mapp. Congratulations and welcome to the Drama Club.
Lucy and the Bully by Claire Alexander. At school, everyone wanted Lucy to draw for them. Well, not quite everyone. Tommy went over to Lucy's table. "Oops," he said, as he pushed over the paint. He didn't look sorry. "Oh dear," cried Miss Goosey. "Accidents will happen. Let's get this mess cleaned up." The next day, everyone made clay models. Miss Goosey gave Lucy a gold star for her blackbird, even though Miss Goosey thought it was a crow. After school, Lucy carried her model very carefully, so it wouldn't break. Tommy was waiting for her. "Let's see your stupid crow," he said. "It's a blackbird," Lucy stammered. But Tommy grabbed it, and then he stomped on it. "Don't tell me, or else," Tommy said. Lucy put her broken black bird in her bag so her mother wouldn't see, and she didn't say anything. That night, Lucy tried hard to put her black bird back together, but it didn't look the same. "What happened to your model?" her mother asked. I dropped it," said Lucy. Over the next week, Lucy's mother wondered what was wrong. On Monday, Lucy brought home a ripped storybook. On Tuesday, she brought home a crumbled painting. And on Wednesday, all her pencils were broken. Lucy looked sadder and sadder every day, but she wouldn't tell her mother why. On Thursday, Lucy brought home a cake she'd made at school. "Who put a hoof print in the middle of it?" her mother asked. I don't know," said Lucy. But at last she said, "It was Tommy." "Don't worry, honey, I'll take care of this," Lucy's mother said. She picked up the telephone. "May I speak to Miss Goosey, please?" she asked. "No, Mommy," Lucy wailed. "Please don't tell Miss Goosey," but it was too late. That night, Lucy couldn't sleep. She was afraid of what would happen the next day. In the morning, Lucy didn't want to go to school. "Don't worry, it will be okay," said her mother. Tommy didn't want to go to school either. At story time, Tommy was very quiet. At playtime, Tommy looked very alone and very sad. Lucy wasn't scared of him anymore. She even felt a little sorry for him. At art time, Lucy saw Tommy drawing. He was drawing a porcupine, and it was a very good porcupine. Its spines looked very sharp. Lucy decided to tell him exactly what she thought of it. "I like your porcupine, Tommy," said Lucy. "It's not a porcupine. It's a hedgehog," said Tommy. "Well, it's very good," said Lucy. "Could you draw one for me, too?" Tommy was very surprised. No one had ever asked him to draw anything before. "You can have this one," said Tommy. "Thank you, Tommy," said Lucy. "I'm sorry, I was mean, and did all those things. And most of all, I'm sorry I stomped on your crow," Tommy said. "It was a very good crow." "I forgive you, Tommy," said Lucy. "But it wasn't a crow, it was a blackbird." They both laughed, and then they went outside to play.